Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the workshop on resume writing conducted by ABS Engineering College. This workshop has been designed specially for diploma engineers. Now, when we say resume writing, so does it mean that I have to write my resume at the same time when I'm going for the job? No. It means that I have to prepare a document. I have to prepare my resume when I apply for any job. This is the document that speaks about myself in my absence. This is the document that creates my first impression. Ladies and gentlemen, resume is not a very easy thing. We should not take resume very casually. Rather, you know, what we generally do, we do copy paste of, you know, some other resumes to ourselves. Except, you know, some names and father's name, we do all cut and copy paste. My dear friends, it is not possible that the other person has the competencies. I would also will have the same kind of competencies. So I would suggest you not to copy and paste some other's resume. Just prepare your own resume. And when the question comes to you that how to prepare my effective resume, correct? How to prepare my effective resume? Now, you know, a lot of people have this question in their mind that, what to write in the resume, how to mention those skills in the resume, right? So in this 5 minutes video, 6 minutes video, I would like to let you know all the aspects of resume. What is resume, why resume is important, and what are the ingredients that will be mentioned in the resume? How can we make our resume error free? Correct. So let me take you to the very first slide of this topic. And this is yes. So this question, you know, is there to you to answer that is your resume, right, a summary of your academics and work history? When somebody asks this question, that what is resume, we generally speak about it. We generally answer this question, which is there on your screen, that, sir, it is a summary of my academics and work history. Is it? Now, the question is no. This is not the summary of my academics and work history. When it is not the summary of these academics and work history, then what is my resume? So the question, the answer is here. Your resume is a true depiction of your personality. This is, you know, the document that speaks about you, that speaks about your background, that speaks about your accomplishments in your absence. So we should not take resume in casually, or we should not prepare this document, my selling brochure. Resume interview is what? Interview is a selling process where I'm selling my key skills, right? And this resume is the document. This resume is the brochure by which I'm selling, you know, those skills, that those set of skills, right? So this resume is a complete or a true depiction of all these points: my personality, my background, my capabilities, abilities, which we talk about, which we talk about are, you know, strengths, accomplishments, and, you know, how organized I am, and my sense of quality, how beautifully I mention those points. I present my points, I present myself, right? So resume is nothing, it's an advertisement, it's a kind of brochure when I'm selling my skills to the interviewer. Okay, now what can a resume will do for you? So this is the biggest question that we, you know, one should know, that what is the importance of resume? What is the need of resume? When I am going for the interview and I can speak directly about myself, all the things that interviewer is asking me, still, you know, I have to prepare my resume. So the question is there on your screen that yes, resume is one thing that creates first impression about you. This is the first thing that creates first impression about you, right? Second is that yes, interview, this resume, you know, how resume help you? It helps me in organizing my thoughts. When I have to speak about myself, because, you know, the biggest question that I've seen in interviews, interviewers generally ask that, tell me something about yourself. And, you know, this is the biggest question when everybody, you know, gets blank. So what to speak about myself is nothing. It's about taking myself through the resume, starting from my name, then, you know, the academic background, skills, and also the sequence that I have mentioned about myself in the resume, I can speak directly about it, right? It is the document where I am writing something about my education, I'm writing something about my experience, and, you know, the positiveness or the points that I am writing there about creating values to the organization, creating values to my end users. So this resume does, you know, a lot for you. This resume is there, you know, when we say about getting a job. So from where you get a job, you get a job, you know, through the process where you are getting shortlisted. And this resume is the key thing which would help you in getting shortlisted for the job. So when you are shortlisted for the job, then again you have you know, the chances to prove yourself, you have chances to speak about yourself. Otherwise you will not be you know, getting chances to talk about yourself, right? So resume is the thing, resume is the document that increases my chances to get shortlisted about the interview, right? Now, these are the essentials. These are the key points of resume, key ingredients of resume. I told you that we generally have a question in our mind that what should I write in my resume? What should I not write in my resume? What should I avoid in the resume? So these are the key points that we should, or rather I would say we must, write in our resume. The career objective, this is the personal statement that I should write in the beginning of the resume. After that, you know, yes, this is not actually the sequence. Personal details can be written, you know, those personal details that we write about, date of birth and all, can be written at the end, as we start with the name, Anna, and contact number, email ID and all. I already discussed, you know, in the previous seminar, the format of the resume, right? So now these are the key ingredients: educational qualification, professional experience, technical qualification, your core competencies, which you talk about, you know, our strengths, our technical strengths, technical competencies, and then, you know, skills, the area of expertise. We talk about our achievements, and finally we have to write some references that are there to prove myself that yes, whatever I'm writing in my resume, it is absolutely true, absolutely correct. Okay, next is, so now I know that what is my resume. It is a document that is there to present myself to the interviewers, right? Next was, what were the key ingredients? So we talked about the skills that, or we talked about the points that we have to mention in the resume. Now, I know the points, but how can I write, you know, those points in the resume, right? How can I make my resume effective? So these are the tips that would help you in writing an effective resume. So the first is that your resume should be very specific, very appropriate. Do not share only one resume with all the organization. No, customization of resume is always needed. Now, customization means I should write my resume, I should write my career objective, I should write my technical competencies according to the organization, according to the job description given by the organization, right? We generally believe in, you know, sharing one standard copy of resume with all the organization. No, this is not the fact that I'm sharing just one copy, because, you know, customization is what is the need of one organization. Suppose one organization is willing to hire people who are very good in presentation, communication, and personal effectiveness. So I should highlight these points in that resume. There is another organization which is willing to hire people who have done some projects on technical competencies, or the students who have done, you know, some technical certifications. So in that scenario, you know, I have to highlight those technical certifications. And in technical certifications, again, you know, it varies, you know, vertical to vertical, it varies from branch to branch, right? So my resume should be company specific. Next is, yes, highlighting my strengths. So this is another, you know, tips where I have to create an effective resume, and that is, you know, I have to highlight those strengths. Strengths is again the key skills. Strengths could be your technical competencies, strengths could be your personal competencies. And how to highlight my strengths is that first do SWOT analysis of your job description. What are the key requirements? What are the key skills required to get the job? And then do SWOT analysis of your strengths with those key skills required. And yes, highlight those specific achievements, highlight those skills, highlight, you know, those the technical part, especially, you know, the projects in your resume. Correct? Okay. And yes, this is very important. Very important that yes, my resume should be very short and simple. It should not be like 3-4 pages resume. It should be for freshers, it should be just 1-page resume or maximum 2 pages resume, right? So and when I say simple means all the key highlights that I discussed on the second slide, my academic background, technical skills, personal strengths, competencies, right, achievements. So all the points that I have to mention, they are placed beautifully, right? The headings are placed beautifully, and also we need to take care of the size of the resume, the text size and the heading size. So let me share here is that you can choose the font which should not be in the italic style. It should be the simple one. Any of the formats is absolutely fine, which is there to look like simple. The text size should not be of more than 12, right? And heading size 14, and the name heading should be the larger one, the largest one. It should be with 16 as the size, right? So text size is very important. Heading size is very important. And writing the content on the, you know, under the headings is also very important. Do not write the complete sentences, just write the key points in the resume, because this is your resume. Never start any sentence with I do this, I did this, and I want to do this. No, it is did this, want to do this, right, and willing to do this. Correct. So this is about, you know, the key highlighting key points. And of course, on the same slide, you can see something which is in, you know, red, chronological order. So what is that chronological order? It is about my experience. It is about my qualification. For freshers, it's about my qualifications. So qualification is from latest to the previous one. You can start with your diploma, then, you know, 10th or 12th, whatever you have done in your academics. Correct. So we go this way, right? And yes, this is another very important tips to write an effective resume is ensure correctness. Your resume should be error-free. Error-free means no grammatical mistakes, no spelling mistakes, and no fake information about yourself. Please understand, if there is any fake information about you, if you're writing anything fake, be careful. You have zero chances to get hired. Interviewers are very smart people. They can easily identify whether you are speaking or you're writing those information about you correctly or fake. And yes, the last takeaway of this session is that your resume is a simple marketing brochure for you. As I discussed in the beginning, that it is nothing. It's a document. It's a brochure, marketing brochure for you, where you are there to sell your technical competencies, personal competencies, your skills, your set of skills, right? And with this, I would like to wind up the session. I hope you liked it. And would request you to prepare your own resume, to write your own resume. Do not cut, copy, paste. Do not follow this funda of cutting, copying, and pasting the others' resumes. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.